the best of the best going to be happening here. But ladies and gentlemen, Sunspot going up against Burmese Ghost, lower brackets right now in the top six, game number one. How will the drops go here, Husky?
Well, first of all, Esmeralda and X-Borg eliminated from the hero pool, no surprise. Burmese Ghost, again, I want to see Panda playing other heroes other than that Jolhe. He needs the they need the diversity right now. Jolhe was a great X factor in Group B, but you are in the playoffs. If Jolhe was your best pocket strat, then Burmese Ghost will be in trouble.
Wow, seems to me Sunsparks, they don't really care about the mana here. According to them here, they banned the Esmeralda and Lilia, which was priority picks for Kid 001 here. Basically, they are going for a double mage ban coming from Sunspot to open things up where they're going to leave a lot of tanks in the pool here. So in this case, will they force Burmese Ghoul to actually pick the Harry for themselves? We saw how Kid 001 was a beast on the Harry during the Grease stages as well.
It's either that or maybe the Lunox, but you don't really want to open up the draft with the Lunox, so Burmese Ghost with a bit less less chances when it comes to their first pick mage. They ban out the Kimi, and right now, all the tanks are up on the table. If you're Sunsparks, you can go for the Karja. We've seen Tolda prioritize the Karja. There's the Kufra as well, there's the Grog. You can go down the list, but they can also first pick the Harith if they want to. They have the advantage to just leave that one tank for the second phase.
There's so many heroes in the pool for this first matchup as well. So I'm looking forward to see how they're going to be picking this phase here. Like you mentioned as well, which tanks are they going to go? However, one thing considered here, the Masha is still in the pool, but seems to me they will prioritize the Harith away from Sunspot. So this pretty much limits the entire mage pool here from the side of Burmese Ghouls. But Burmese Ghouls open things up here with the Kufra and the Karja to deal with this Harith now.
Yeah, Sunsparks just breezing through the draft right now. The Harith first pick on point. Grog and Masha will be the next two. They kind of thought of this. Do we really want to go for the Kufra? Because like you mentioned, if Kid 001 does play the Harith, he does play the Lunox, if we can't go for the Kufra opening or any other tank, you are giving that Harith away because so many tanks, almost all the tanks, are on the table. Sunsparks have a lot of options to go for, so they don't mind first picking the Harith.
Yeah, it seems to me there seems to be a roster change here coming from Sunspark that Rafflesia is actually not playing.
Rafflesia is there? Yeah. Did you not see Rafflesia?
Oh wait, yeah, I can see Rafflesia now. Oh my god.
Oh my goodness.
Oh my goodness, I'm bright now. I need four glasses, oh, I have five glasses now.
But Lunox will be the choice, the main choice for Kid 001 on the side of Burmese Ghost. They kind of ran off option. They talk about counterpicking what the opponents pick, but Sunsparks, well, they're target banning this mage right now. They know, other than striking Panda on that possible draw hit, which I find highly unlikely in this game, they strike the mage of Burmese Ghouls. Thamus will be banned out by Sunsparks. We won't be seeing DR signature Thamus, but they already have the Masha, so it doesn't really matter too much.
Oh yeah, speaking of which, you talked about the Lunox, right? But opening this off here, Sunspark, they still have an alternative tank for them to decide here. They may consider just banning off the Lolita just because of how Lunox is a little bit worried about that here. The shield pretty much shuts down whatever that Lunox tries to do with the darkness in this order. But in this case, Masha is pretty much in the pool. We're going to see a lot of split push potential. I'm worried here from Sunspark's group because in terms of rotation and mobility to rotate from lanes to lanes is not exactly favoring from the side of Burmese Ghouls unless they go for double arrivals here on the Kufra as well as their offlane here. But in this case, who is going to be offlane here? Thamus pretty much banned here from side of Burmese Ghouls, so we might see a Jolhe here coming from Burmese Ghouls.
Yeah, the Jolhe, Sunspot is basically daring Burmese Ghouls to go for that Jolhe again because they are ready to take on this hero. I think Burmese Sunspot, they can still kind of go for a Cho if you want to. Cho is kind of the niche pick that some teams do go for. And Burmese Ghouls, the Lunox pick, you talk about the double arrival on the tanks. I believe Tennis Gaming Plus were the first team to put the arrival on their Kufra, to put the arrival on their Grog or Archive. But Burmese Ghouls, they go back to the Bruno, a hero that we just don't really see the effectiveness. Sunsparks, they lock in Lolita and Ranger.
Yeah, this is pretty much their drafts here coming from Sunsparks, and I am liking this a lot coming in from Sunsparks just because they have the answer to deal with the Lunox. But you talked about the Terrisla here. It was played from the side of Sunsparks, but this time Burmese Ghoul is going to play it on Panda. This is where the Arrival is going to do fantastically well. But I'm a little bit worried here from side of Burmese Ghoul, because Teresa, they may have the burst damage here, but Masha will definitely have the advantage in terms of the attack speed here. But it's going to be a 50-50 drop, ladies and gentlemen, here. We are going to be hit into a game number one between both these teams here. I'm not too sure about who's going to come out this year, but whoever takes games one will set the entire tempo for both these teams. As you can see, ladies and gentlemen, here, the drafters and coach from each team going for a handshake, and this will be the crown of the M1 World Championships.
Yep, the handshake, the ceremonial handshake to start things off. No better way. These two teams have not met each other yet, so the only studies that they can do is by watching the previous matches that they respectively played. The Terrizla, I pointed out, right, and you emphasized on it. Sunspot played Terrizla yesterday. Burmese Ghouls, I want to see them off of that jaw hit, and they did. They picked out the Terrizla for Panda. Now is Panda's time to show that he can play heroes outside of that jaw hit.
Definitely here, and at the same time as well, as a quote once said by the guys from Kinjas, respect all, fear none. Who will come off the top? That's the thing here. But that's the thing, right? And when we talked about the drafts here, we saw how they were able to draft all these picks here coming in. Sunsparks, they have the Lolita to deal with the Lunox. We saw the Bruno pick up from the side of Burmese Ghouls, which is kind of interesting as well, but it definitely pierces through the damages of Masha and what Grok has to offer as well in terms of creed department here. So Kufra to shut down the Harith here. So they both have individual counters for each other, but it's not complete counters to each other. So it's going to be a It is going to come down towards the guts and wills between both these teams and who will come on top. The early phase is going to be one of the most important factors coming from both these teams.
Yeah, and the Bruno is one of Burmese Ghouls' comfort pick. As we take a look at the map right now, the Celestial Palace, a first look on day two. But yeah, the Bruno is one of Burmese Ghouls' comfort pick. A007 got two Maniacs in Group B using that hero, and now they're gonna put him on this hero again and hope that he works magic. But the question is, how is Burmese Ghoul going to control this tempo against Sunspark? Because Sunspark, they have shown extreme composure when they went up against BFM yesterday.
Definitely here, as you can see, the players are getting ready. You're teleporting in towards the Celestial Palace. As Husky said here, we are gonna be heading off in towards game number one, ladies and gentlemen. You can see the fans are roaring for Sunspark. Is this going to be a Filipino day, or is it going to be Myanmar taking game number one in this day two World Championships? We shall see. Based on the draft, I'm not sure who's going to win here. Are you guys ready? Because why? We are ready, ladies and gentlemen. Here, this is game number one for Sunspark going up against Burmese Ghouls.
Oh, the fan in the live stadium of Axiata Arena, definitely more towards Sunspark, the Filipino crowd going bonkers. Burmese Ghouls, they don't have to fret too much. They do have their own supporters, maybe online watching on the English stream right now on YouTube Gaming. But again, Burmese Ghouls, they love this kind of aggression, and they're trying to pressure JP. They forced the recall from Fuzekin already. This round will have to abandon that Granger, and an immediate invade from Burmese Ghouls.
Definitely here, you're going to be trading after trading here. Sunspark scouts this opposition as well. They will do exactly the same. However, they're a little bit later party here. Burmese Ghouls, they're thinking about contesting here. Will he be able to steal here? The Kufra comes in. Unfortunately, doesn't have well, but the bouncy ball catches up to him. He will get busted out. But K001 joins the Panda as Burmese Ghouls get a double kill and a return here.
Yep, and Burmese Ghouls, they start things off with two kills. Sunspark, they want to go for the invade. They want to match what Burmese Ghouls are trying to do, but the mirror does reflect in Burmese Ghouls' favor. So that two opening kills, Panda, Terrizla managing to zone out the rest of Sunspark to give this Lunox a 2-0-0 in 1 minute. This is what Burmese Ghouls want.
Yeah, that's the thing, right? If you think about it here, yeah, Panda was able to clip kill relatively quickly as compared to what Rafflesia has to offer. And because of that, they have that this slight 10-5 second window ahead of Sunspark. And because of that, they were able to capitalize on that rotation here. So Burmese Ghoul doing fantastic well in this early phase by before the 2 minute mark. And Panda, we're up against Renzio right now. They're trading blows after blows. And this is what I'm talking about. Panda may have the damage coming from Teresa, but this Masha is going to be able to outstop anything here. But however, we're going to be seeing a fight later on.
Yep, and as a fight later on, get the replay out of the way. I want to see the action. Harry already slain the Kaja, but now Audio Brilliant does come out from Kid001, KLVJ, trying to run away to Harry with the Chrono Dash, not able to get out. Ice Ice on top of him with the bouncing ball, and he'll take it down. Renzo jumps right in, gets the cool front in return, and now he turns it onto that Bruno, but Kid001 is there. Woods again joins the fight, but not able to do too much. Maybe he overextended. They will score the goal onto him. Mega kill for Kid001.
Mistakes were made here from Fuzaken. However, he has the level 3 just now. If he had the wall charge, things would have been a little bit different here. But Burmese Go, they took advantage of the situation. Kid001 with the turtle buff now, using the penetrations coming in from the darkness here, piercing through towards the armors of Sunspot. What a play indeed. Burmese Go 5-3 now, their 2k advantage. Will they be able to uphold their title later on?
Yeah, Burmese Ghost coming to life again. This was the Burmese Ghost from Group B, and I'm happy to see them back up against Sunsparks, the champion from the Philippines, the one that reverse sweep Onyx Philippines. Well, when the runner-up got kind of had an upset, right? Had a really bad run in Group D. But Burmese Ghost now lead 5-3. Go grab, showing them in the lead. Not too much, only 1,200, but it's the lead that they need.
Yes, definitely here at the same time. Panda doesn't have the mana warping. He tried to throw the vision, but Renzo getting focused down. Oh. Ice, ooh, missing the Tyrant's Rage. And Renzo will be very fortunate here. But like you said, Kaja coming in, Divine Judgment still available, but Renzo does recover his HP bar, so he's going to be A-OK. And we've talked about how strong the Masha is. That's exactly why he's so strong.
Panda actually having such a good time now. Sunsparks, four members down to the bottom lane, in the middle blast get charged up. Panda to execute the strike, does knock them out, but I don't think he can get out of this. And it's going to be KLVJ picking up the kill.
Yeah, they're going to be trading a tower as well from side of Burmese Ghost up top side. They're taking this tier 2 tower relatively low, but unfortunately say they could not take it in time. But Sunspark, they're trying to be in a little bit of greed here to take the tier 2s. No arrivals yet from side of Burmese Ghost. Ice is on the side, catches on the higher rim here. Can he go for the solo kill from side kill VJ? He's going for the Tyrant's Rage, connects as well, but unfortunately no follow up here. Panda with the arrival. Can he go for the swing? Kill VJ pops the Xamarin Frost, and they will disengage.
Ooh,
Ice with the forward as well. The stars are revealed. Ice, can you go for the follow-up one from the side?
Wow.
Baby, they come in, Kid001 with the darkness, goes for the wraparound, and double kill from Burmese Ghost.
The commitment from Burmese Ghost was perfect. Sunspark did not expect the immediate collapse. They come in, they take three. Two of the calls for Sunspark were eliminated from that, and Sunspark, slight criticism right there. They stayed too long for that second tier. There was no way it was going to be taken down. But commendation to Ice, he followed through, he had trust, the rest of the ghouls were swarming in for that buffet and they would take it.
My oh my, Burmese Ghouls, they have the advantage, but now the turtle buff getting contested as well. Tries to go for a little bit of snipe here with the Grog, unfortunately doesn't seem to connect here, and they will disengage in this fight here from the side of Burmese Ghouls. Nice try there for Fuzaken, however, Burmese Ghouls, 3k advantage here, they are going to be keeping up with the pressure as of now.
Exactly, and whoever wins this best of three will lock in top four, and Burmese Ghouls are looking for that advantage. Now, 9-4, they are extending that goalie, they got the turtle. Sunsparks, they don't have to be too worried, they can still come back. You have Grog and the Lolita, especially the Harith as well, always good scaling into that late game. The only issue that they have to deal with it right now is Kid001 on that 6-0 Luna. Now they're gonna engage on the Panda, the penalty zone, and he's gonna knock two members out, but again, they ambush him and they kill him off.
Nicely done there from Sunspark, a little bit of casualty price. However, Burmese Ghouls will immediately trade the tier 2 up top. Objective is the key here coming from Burmese Ghouls. And Rafflesia, they're setting up the here. Kid001 is there, but no follow-up available. He's up on brightness form and he can't go for the audio brilliance. Anime turret will be pressured off here, but the turtle will be finished in 50 seconds. Sunspark, they need those timings, and Burmese Ghouls seems to be applying the pressure here, and they're also setting up shop in case Sunspark walks in towards the trap.
Good thing from Sunsparks, they managed to push out the side waves. The Masha, maybe the recall in time, but they got the Renzo on the Divine Judgment. Renzo tried to fight back with the stab with the Wild Charge, but not able to save this Masha. Now KLVJ dashes him with a Chrono Dash. Burmese Ghouls, they get out with that kill.
Yeah, they set up shop here from side of Burmese Ghouls. They got what they needed here. Masha, definitely a great target for them. And Burmese Ghouls, as of now, they're taking advantage of the situation here to apply even more pressure, stealing away the buff away from Sunsparks here, dragging this fight in towards the next turtle fight as well. And it seems to me Burmese Ghouls, they will have the advantage now just because they know how ahead here. They lose Panda up top from side Sunspots. Maybe this is the opening game for Sunspots to contest Burmese Ghouls.
Full second. Goes in with a power of nature, but immediately Renzo gets dragged back. Divine Judgment will send him to the death. Kid is now legendary. They get to engage on the ice, but Burmese Ghouls will retreat cleanly for that third turtle.
Great decision here coming from Burmese Ghouls, taking that Divine Judgment from the side of Maybe, just because they saw the guys up top from side Sunspox, and because of the decision, they knew the Masha was alone. They were not ready to take a fight with Burmese Ghouls from the side of Sunspox. Great decision overall coming from Maybe.
And Sunsprout now, they lose the entire control. They do not have any territorial advantage in that bottom jungle. Burmese Ghouls, they took three turtles. All the advantage is now in their sight. They can go for that last tier 2 and prep for that Lord and go for the high ground siege. You can see Sunsprout falls back into their base, all the legs exposed, and Burmese Ghouls in total control.
Definitely here, and like you said as well, Burmese Ghouls, they have the control. The next long fight, but here
Shadow comes Mask.
Divine Judgment from Maybe. They get the low leader. Sunsparks, oh no! It's Kanda, penalty zone from Panda, doesn't connect. Big swing here from Boots again with the wall charge. Can't seem to defend against this here, but Burmese Ghouls, they're taking the tier 2 in the middle side here. They're looking for more, and they are thinking about closing this game before the lock comes in. The turtle buff still available. Superstars of Sunsparks, what they can do here?
Ice missed the thing engage, but they drag the Harry back, and Kid will find the kill that they need. Now, auto brilliance comes out. Sunsparks, four members, they can still hold on against Burmese Ghouls for a bit while, but that Shadow Mask into the Flicker Divine Judgment started this whole avalanche up. Burmese Ghouls still have one lane to go, but Sunspark thinks it's like looking bleak for them. Uh-oh. In that game one, the final shot, but they flick on top of it and they take out a Bruno.
That is a great kill here from Sunspark. They need more than that here. As of now, Burmese Ghouls, they've lost the A007 and Panda. They can buy a little bit of time here, 15 seconds before the Lord recovers here, and Sunsparks, they're thinking about pushing up the map. Will they be able to pressure here? 9 seconds left, and off the kill feed as well. You see Fuzo going to be providing Lord assist from Renzo to potentially try and snipe the Lord if Burmese Ghouls go for the contestant.
They need all five members in that Lord pit. Both middle and bottom inhibitors have been taken down, which means that the priority for Sunsparks now, push out those two waves, make sure the top wave isn't pushing in, and congregate at that Lord area. They only have one chance, they only have one fight against Burmese Ghouls, and they cannot mess this up. The gold grab doesn't matter at this point because Burmese Ghouls are in so much control. They are now prepping for the Lord.
Burmese Ghouls, as of now, they have the perfect defense. Kid 001, 10-0 CFM3, just got his Holy Crest as well. Sunsparks, they need to be careful here, but you can see the Kumbra starting this. The Lord Storm is here. Rafinha with the out here. Doesn't connect. Zaman Force available. Who's gonna get the Lord? He's gonna be in there. The Burmese Ghouls. They're trying to take this fight. They will come on top. Oh no. It's a disaster for Sunsparks. They will lose everyone. Renzo on the run. Burmese Ghouls. They're giving them the run for their money. They're trying to take him down. Double kill for everyone.
And it's 10 seconds until Lolita comes back. Renzo, he needs 10 seconds, but Burmese Ghouls not going to give him that. They're going to work on the crystal straight away. Myanmar, is this the first crystal of the series? They are looking for first blood, and they will draw it! Burmese Ghouls lead the series 1-0.
Burmese Ghouls.